not talking about you talking to Satan, but I'm talking about you talking to one of his evangelists that you talk to. Somebody that pumped you up in front of you, but only had your bad interest at heart. They didn't have your best interest at heart. They wanted to kill you. They wanted to steal your joy. They wanted to steal your purpose. They wanted to kill your anointing. But what did we do? We opened up our mouth and released what God was getting ready to do. And then wondered why the enemy showed you. You told him what you were getting ready to do or what God had in store for you. The enemy don't know what God's getting ready to do, but unless we open up our mouth and tell him. So therefore, when we got to get in our place with God, we got to learn how to sometimes keep our mouth shut. You can't always release what God's getting ready to do, because the enemy is sitting waiting. Matter of fact, you ought to look at your neighbor now and say, I love you, but I don't trust you that much, because of the fact that I got to learn how to keep something that the Lord said to me between me and the Lord. Every now and then when I open up my mouth, I have the tendency to release things that God himself told me to keep to myself. Hezekiah understood that I'm not running to nobody else and asking them, how can I get my house in order? But I'm going to the only one that can set me up in order. I'm going to the only one that can work it out in my life. I'm going to the only one that can turn me from my wicked ways and plant me back on the right path with him. Can I preach to somebody and tell you that all you got to do to get back on the right, you ain't got to jump through hula hoops, you ain't got to run an obstacle course, but all you got to do is go to God in prayer. I'm going to God for myself. I don't need another prayer line. I don't need another prayer partner. I don't need to call CBN. I don't need to call TBN. I don't need to call the Word Network, but I know that I got a network by myself when I put the Word in my life and I learned how to do like James did and walk the Word and not be just a hearer of the Word, then I know that I can connect with the God that serves, sit high and looks low. I can sit and talk with God, tell God all of my problems, and God will answer my prayers. Anybody ever had any prayers answered? Anybody ever had a prayer answered? Anybody can testify that I'm only here because God not only heard the prayer that I spoke to him, but he heard the prayer that my heart murmured. I'm so glad that even when I don't have the articulation of speech, and even when I can't formulate the word, if my heart cries out to God, then God will answer my prayers. I'm so glad that even in the midst of a storm, when I can't even open up my mouth, God still looks beyond my thoughts and sees my needs. I've been on that thing for a few weeks now, because it's only the fact that he looked beyond our thoughts that we're able to sit up in here today. It's only because of the fact that God, he knew what we were going through, and he knew we were going to make mistakes, but he still saw fit to wake us up this morning and start us on our way. Is anybody ready to praise God because of the fact that God didn't take you out when you should have been taken out, but what God did when you went to him in prayer? Father, forgive me for my sins. Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help shall I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, where will I go? I thank the Lord this morning for the fact that he gave us not just a first chance, but he gave us multiple chances to go to him in prayer. Hezekiah turned his face to the wall, because if I look at the wall, I can't see none of my haters. I can't see nobody who's conspiring against me.
Amen.
I can't see nobody that's hating on me, or nobody that's praying against you. You do know you got some folk praying against you, right? That thing that the Lord told you that you were going to be able to do, the minute you released it, folks start praying against you. I know where they come from. I know what they used to do. I know they got a past. Well, I'm glad you know that I got a past, so you know that can't nobody do me like Jesus can. Can't nobody bring me up like God can. Can't nobody change my life like God can. Hezekiah was getting ready to die, but he went to the Lord in prayer. Literally, I spoke to an ex-offender re-entry program yesterday here, and the spirit just dropped. It was a concert, and the spirit just dropped. And literally, I began to work the altar and work the crowd for a moment, and I told them, I said, we're all ex-offenders, yes. And we're still offenders now. You may not be breaking the law of man, but we break the law of God. And just as though we're trying to get a re-entry program together for the city, God says, I got a re-entry program together for you. Because he's the only one that can turn a sinner into a saint. And that's why I worship God like I do. Because even though I got a past, I'm so glad that my past is not my present.
Yes.
Is there anybody up in here that's been delivered from something? God changed you. God revived you. God rejuvenated you. The world had already signed a TNR, but I'm so glad that God came and resuscitated me and made me live again. Glad, even though Lazarus was dead for 4 days, even in my dead state, God still called me by name. Is there anybody up in here that God called you by name? You were on your way to hell. You were on your way to the grave. But God saw fit to call you by your name and say, loose my child and let my child go. I need the prayer warriors up in here to know that God will bless you if you go to him in prayer. He turned from his wicked ways and God added to his life. Can I preach to somebody? The reason God ain't added to your life is you have yet to come to him. You have yet to go to God in prayer. We spend so much time negating prayer and tearing down prayer and thinking negatively about prayer. But God said, prayer still works.
Amen.
He says, just like I added to Hezekiah, I can add to you too. You just have to turn from some stuff. Ah, here it is. The revelation of that is this. Some of the stuff you think is blessing you, it's the very stuff that's cursing you. See, the devil can give you a blessing too. People don't like that type of talk. The devil can't bless you. That's a lie. He can bless you according to the world standards. But I